Celebrating 90 years, Mr. George Vaughn, born January 13, 1932. George Herman Vaughn was born in 1932. That's also the same year that the amazing Babe Ruth hit his famous called shot. Fred Astaire had the number one song, and the Polaroid camera was invented. Gas was only 18 cents a gallon. Can you imagine? There was definitely some good things going on in 1932. At the same time, to quote a line from Charles Dickens, it was the best of times and it was the worst of times. Adolf Hitler was gaining power. The Great Depression hit. And America was still segregated. Regardless of those things, nothing could stop God's plan for George's life. At the time George was born, the Protestant church was thriving and growing in power.
When I was growing up, segregation in the South was really, really strong. And there were only certain fields that you could be in if you were black, like in my case, my mom was Native American. And so the Native Americans were treated just like the blacks. But we also know that many of the blacks didn't like me because they thought, that I thought, because my skin was lighter, that I was better.
So you got the bad side from both, right?
Yes. Especially one particular one, his name was George. And he was called Big George and I was Little George. And Little George was the one that I got along with everybody. Because I had people of non-color that were friends when I was growing up. Boys and girls. As a matter of fact, some of the guys wanted to beat me up because they said I had a white girlfriend.
George was born in South Fulton, Tennessee, near the Kentucky line. His mother was Mildred Stitch and his father Herman Vaughn. Unfortunately, his mother passed away when he was 18 months old. He was raised by his dear Aunt Lily. He moved to Kentucky, where he went to Oakton Grammar and Higman High School. At Higman High School, he graduated as a salutatorian. Go, Mr. George!
My aunt was told by my birth mama before she died that if anything happens, she said it like so, if anything happened to me, I do not want George Herman to go with his dad. You take him. And not only that, you take him and raise him like he was your own child.
And she did that for you, right?
She did that.
How old were you when you lost your mama?
18 months old. Year and 6 months.
So God must have showed your mama that for her to have.
Well, my dad was something else. My natural father, he'd work, and then he would do other things that were ungodly. And at one time, I really wanted to be with him. And I was so thankful when I found out that Mom had told him that I didn't go. And he got sick. And he apologized about being the way that he was.
George went to Kentucky State University right after high school. He had big dreams and high hopes. After all, he had been the salutatorian. He knew he had the capacity to fulfill his dreams. It didn't take him too long to learn that he was quite popular with the ladies. It wasn't all fun and games, though. George encountered monumental situations that developed his grit and character that would last him throughout his whole life.
I heard a story about when you were in college. When you first started college, you were coming in to Kentucky State, and you had been the salutatorian for your high school. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay.
In high school.
In high school. Okay. And so when you went into college, you wanted to be an engineer?
Yes.
But you switched.
I wanted to be an electronic engineer. Yes.
Okay. And you changed your major to elementary education?
Yes.
Okay. And how come you did that?
Well, because it was so segregated back then, they said that I couldn't be an engineer.
So, essentially, they didn't let you be an engineer because you were black?
Yes. And Native American.
So, you continued on with school for 2 years?
Yes.
Even after that?
Yes.
And then your aunt was sick, the aunt who raised you. And you left school to go see about her, right?
Yes.
George was drafted into the military in 1954. By 1955, he was leaving New York City for Germany. That was a chaotic time in America. That same year, Rosa Parks took her unforgettable seat on the bus. A young Martin Luther King was speaking to thousands, telling them to always fight with love. Martin Luther King's speeches, they weren't just great speeches to George Herman Vaughn. No, they reflected a way of life, problems, racism, discrimination, segregation, all the things that he had experienced during his lifetime. And George himself echoed the mantra, always fight with love. George didn't choose to serve. He was chosen. But when he was chosen, he did it well, and he did it proudly. After serving, George returned home. He spent a few years enjoying bachelor life. He went to work. He went to church. He spent time with his family. And he loved his cars. It was 1975. The Vietnam War had ended. Segregation had been over for 11 years. Gas, 53 cents a gallon. And a Mr. George Herman Vaughn, he was finally ready for a wife.
Tell me about meeting your wife. I know you've been married for 46 years. Tell me about when you met her.
Well, I had heard about her from telling me, oh, I'll meet this girl. He was going through those motions.
His name is George.
Yeah. You ought to meet this girl. She is great. And I laughed up a breeze. I just laughed and laughed. What is George talking about? He's telling me about this great girl from Gary and him. And how I should see her. As a matter of fact, he pretended to me, tried to get me to believe, that she was his girlfriend.
Oh.
And I didn't believe it. And I was right. She wasn't. But anyway, when I met her, I said, wow, this girl is not a fox. She dynamite! And I was told later that I used the word dynamite for her before the guy on the
Jay
you won, didn't you?
I won.
Did that end your friendship with the other George?
No.
Well, kind of, because he sent his brother to beat you up.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that.
But you got the girl.
He sent his brother, and the brother was going to beat me up because I had taken George done took my brother's girlfriend. Yeah.
And she had four kids, right?
She had four kids at the time.
And you didn't hesitate to take them on and to be their dad?
No. And matter of fact, they liked me.
December 18th, 1975, George married Sheila. And together, with Sheila's four children, who he instantly considered his own children, became the Vaughn family, a very successful, happy, blended family. Nothing means more to George than God. Second to God is Sheila and their children. They built a beautiful life together. George graduated from DeVry and Sheila became a nurse. They then moved the family to Knoxville, Tennessee, and that's where they still remain. As beautiful as it wasn't without heartaches. They endured many of them through the years, including the loss of two of their boys. However, their love and success and faith in God remained strong and still remain strong through everything. In 2000, George was retirement age, so he retired. Realized he just wasn't done, so he went to work at Walmart. And he made working at Walmart a ministry. The year 2000 was also his 25th anniversary to Sheila. And they renewed their vows and reaffirmed the strength and their love for each other and God.
There were times that I would pray for them. And then sometimes in the prayer, when I finished, they said, that's exactly what I had in mind, but I didn't express it the way you did. And then I'd laugh, and they would laugh.
So you had some of the same customers for 20 years.
Chris.
Yes.
Tell about Chris.
Chris,
the young man who said that he thought of you as his father, because his father...
And the guy was saying that he thought that I was his father. And then he showed a picture of it, so much like his father. And he was wondering when he came down.
You're confused. There's this teenage boy named Chris. And over the years, he kept coming to Walmart. And he always sought George out, because George always talked to him, always encouraged him. And so George was getting ready to quit Walmart. And I said, no, did you pray about it? And he says, well, no. And so he started to pray about it. And so Chris came in one day and he says, you know why I always talk to you? And George said, no. He says, because you're like my father, because my father never took time with me, but you always took time with me. And even when George changed from one Walmart to the other, Chris still kept in touch with him. And he got to know Chris' brothers, too, and his mother. And his mother was really happy because she said, you have made such an impact on my boy.
That's an awesome ministry.
Late in 2016, George won the HIP Award. That's Hero in Place. And that was due largely in part to the way that he turned his job at Walmart into a ministry. But it's also because that person that George is at Walmart, he is everywhere. He is always ready. to minister wherever he is to whomever is in front of him. And back to his mantra that he shared with Dr. King, he always fights with love. 2016 also happens to be the year that George retired from Walmart.
Mr. George, tell me about your faith.
Well, I had heard of faith and read about it. But in those early years of my life, I didn't really understand it. And I wondered what it meant when he said, without faith, you couldn't please Jesus or the Lord. And I said, well, what on earth are you talking about? What is faith? And then he says, faith comes from God. And so I went over those scriptures, and I had a good memory. I could memorize it, but I didn't really understand it until later on in life. And then when I would start to talking, many times other people of non-colorhood, which were black, they were the ones that really gave me a rough time. I had a lot of white friends when I was growing up. A lot of them.
And when did you get to know Jesus?
I guess I really didn't get to know him as Jesus until after I met Sheila. Because she told me something. And I thought, now wait a minute, I ain't been studying all my life and I never heard it. Where did she get that from? And then I prayed about it, and then the Lord let me know that she was right. And I cried like a baby when I found out that I had been wrong. Be, like the Bible says, do unto others as you have them do unto you. Treat people the way you want to be treated.
It's 2022, and life has changed a lot for George and this nation in the past 90 years. Instead of having a Polaroid camera, now we have smartphones with cameras built in. According to Google, the most famous athlete is former wrestler Dwayne The Rock Johnson. And the number one song is by Lauren Spencer Smith. Gas is $3.30 a gallon on average. America is still as divided as it ever was. And George Herman Vaughn has overcome some horrific and atrocious events in life. And he has done it all with grace and dignity and grit. And he has never, ever failed to fight with love. It would make us all wonder how it was possible that he did it.
It was the Lord. I said, the Lord has a way that is different from our way. And it's the Spirit of the Lord.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.